Hello everybody, the point of this video is showing you how to configure a third-party range extender repeater to replace your stock vision repeater range extender. And also, as you can see with my Phantom, I redid my antenna camera mod. I also went and used a thicker gauge cable wire. This is RG178. And these are skew planar antennas, which will give more reliable FPV than a regular linear antenna. And just to show you, this is an example of a helical or a circular polarized antenna, which is what I will be using on here instead of the whip antennas, again to give more reliable coverage. This is an example of an RHCP, right hand circular polarized. If you weren't modifying your Phantom, you would want to use one that is left hand circular polarized, which is rotated in the opposite direction. An RHCP will work with your Phantom, but you will get more reliable function using an LHCP with an unmodified Phantom vision. Anyway, now enough off-topic discussion. Let's get into configuring a third-party repeater. Reasons why you would want to use another one repeater as opposed to your stock are twofold. One would be if you are uncomfortable modifying your stock repeater. Also keep in mind that if you do modify your repeater, it will void the warranty on it. Drilling the holes in here. Second would be if you want to get extended range, because if you get a high output repeater, not all of them are high output, but if you get something that's at least a half a watt or more, preferably something that's closer to a watt or higher, that will also give you far extended range over the stock repeater. Although most decent repeaters are probably going to be at least the same, if not higher power output than the Phantom's repeater, but if you're going to go and buy one, you may as well get something that's higher power. This is a Hawking Technology one. This particular one is discontinued. This is an HWREN1, although I think that the one that replaces this one as their lower end repeater is 500 milliwatt, which will give you good range above and beyond what the stock repeater will do on the Phantom. There's also a couple other brands, one I know of that's a 750 milliwatt and another one that's 1,000 milliwatt power that will give you good range. Continuing on, let's say if you wanted to leave this repeater stock, you could use it for your short range flying, and then you could use this for, let's say, a base station setup. So that's for your long range flying, set up a tripod, have a portable battery, a portable 12 volt DC battery to power this off of, or an up supply, whatever you want to use, so that way you have power going to this, and then this can go to your tripod, which can mount your antennas, whether it be patch antennas or circular polarized antennas, or just using your whips, whatever you want to go with. And anyway, now enough with the introduction. Let's get into how you do it. Most routers, regardless of the manufacturer, are going to be configured in a similar way. You have to connect it to your computer. So I have this hardwired to my computer with my network connection. And you go to a web browser. Most routers have a downloadable utility that can allow you to access a router. But most will allow you to access via your web browser. The IP address of this router is 192.168.1.240. Although I have since changed the IP address for what we need to do it with. But the first step you're going to do to access your router is you're going to go to your networking section. This is XP, but Windows 7 would be basically the same. So you go to your networks, you find your local area network, right-click on it, select properties, and then you go to the TCP/IP protocol. And you're going to change the IP address to the, in this case, since the IP address of my router is 192.168.1.2, the original IP address is 240. I just need to change the IP address to 192.168.1 and any three digits from 1 to 254. In this case, I made it 3. It just can't be the same IP address that the router itself uses. And this is always going to be the same, 255.255.255.0. That's 255.255.255.0. And that's all you do. You click OK. And then you're all set. You're going to need some information from your original router. You're going to want to find out what the MAC ID is and the SSID of your Phantom Vision camera is. There are a couple ways to find that out, but actually by default, the SSID of a Vision camera is going to, as a rule of thumb, it's going to be FC200. That's Frank Charlie 200 underscore the last 6 digits of the MAC address of the camera. So the MAC address is a bunch of numbers separated by colons, like 00:01, or it could be an F. It could be so, but you're going to take those numbers and but without the colons. So let's say, let me show you what my, one way you would find it is going to turning on your repeater here, turning on your Phantom. So then you're going to connect to your app. I'm waiting for the access points to appear. Okay, you see I'm connected to my Phantom. You go to your Phantom Vision app, settings, and you're going to go to binding. When you click on binding, it's going to show you what the the SSID of your camera is. So, here you go. It shows your SSID. And you see these numbers over here? You see a number, colon, a number, colon. So your SSID is going to be FC200 underscore but the last six digits, which are not going to be separated by colons. But you will see the SSID, but just write down the SSD and MAC address of it. Although when you do a site survey, when you're connected to your router, I mean the repeater, it will show you, you'll be able to find the MAC address without having to look for it under here, even though the SSID of the camera is invisible. Let me just back out of here. Now this is not really necessary, but if you look in your over here, this is the DHCP IP information. You might want to just jot it down in case you want to set up a static IP rather than allowing it to go through DHCP. And now let me turn this off and my Phantom. Now let me get into actually configuring the router now. So here's the nitty-gritty. All you have to do to configure any router, any range extender, repeater, is change the IP address of the repeater to 192.168.1.2. So you're going to want to change the settings there. You'll just look in the manual for whatever range extender you buy. Oh, it would help if I plugged it in. Sorry about the delay there. Forgot to plug in the repeater. But you're going to go to your you're going to have a user ID and password. So enter your ID and password. It can be different things depending on the company. Again, just follow the instructions of your range extender. And what the universal thing you will need to do is you see over here, SSID. You're going to need to change the SSID of your repeater to Phantom, as you see here, with an underscore. So it could be underscore and any name, but you need to change the name of your repeater to Phantom with an underscore, and you need to change the IP address of your repeater to 192.168.1.2, as you see over here. And there's going to be a section where you have DHCP server, in this case configuration, no, advanced, in this one it's under advanced settings and then system utilities, and this is where I was able to change the IP address of my router. And I also, by default, most range extenders have the DHCP server disabled. In this case, you have to enable it, although typically they will be disabled, but just enable it, and you can leave it at the default settings that it gives you. In this case, it's starting IP of 100 and ending 200, and then you'll be set with that. So now, under basic settings, alright, I changed the SSID over here from what it really is, but you're going to put site survey. And when you go to site survey, you're going to see a listing of nearby wireless servers, as well as the channel number. The camera's SSID on your vision is invisible, so you're going to see a wireless access point with no SSID, but you will see the MAC ID of it. Let me get a moment here so I can see it. Okay. You see over here, there is an SSID for, this is a random access point that's nearby, and there's one that's blank. The blank one is the one that's coming from my vision camera, and you see it says BSSID, that's the SSID. So you'll take the last six digits of that and use that as your MAC ID, as the name for the camera. So you're going to select the one that has the invisible BSSID, and you're going to choose your main SSID as Phantom underscore and give it whatever name you want. You're not going to change the channel number. You're going to change your root AP SSID to the name that you found when you went to bindings in the Vision app, or if you couldn't find it there, it's going to be FC200 underscore and the last six digits of your SSID. You're not going to use the colons, though, from whatever you saw when you did the site survey. You're just going to do the last six digits. And that's it. You're going to save your settings. And you'll be good to go. Now let me show you. I'll be connecting to the Vision, to Phantom, the Phantom Ben access point. Okay, now I'm in my DJI app. As you see, I'm connected to Phantom Ben. Click on camera. And there you go. And let's shake this puppy around a little bit. So, success. So that's all there is to it. If you want to use a third-party repeater slash range extender, that's the steps. Here's the basic rundown again. You get most any third-party wireless repeater range extender. and you will need to log into that router, change the IP address of the router. So, and I'll write down these steps in the description as well. So you're going to log into Range Extender via web browser. You're going to then change IP address to 192.168.1.2 from whatever it is. Turn on the HCP server. Do a site survey and select the blank one. But of course, before you do that, you should have turned on your Phantom 2 Vision, so that way the Wi-Fi on the camera is actually turned on. So turn on your Phantom 2 Vision, give it a minute, then do a site survey and select the one that has a blank BSS ID. Name your router's the Range Extenders to Phantom _. So it wouldn't be in all caps necessarily, but it needs to be Phantom _ and whatever name, like 1234 or whatever. And that is it. So do your site survey. And the associated SSID of the router is going to be FC200_, the last 6 digits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as an example. So it's the last 6 digits of the MAC, but you're not going to have any colons in it. Again, you can find that name by going to bindings in the DJI app when you're connected to your normal router. But I gave you that other way to create it. And that's it. You're all set. You connect now to your own router, and you will benefit from having a spare router to use, being able to get greater range without having to mod your stock Range Extender at the expense of having a larger unit to deal with that you have to have plugged into either an external battery or up supply. But again, that's how you do it for those of you that are interested. Anyway, I hope you were able to follow this video okay, and that it wasn't too long-winded. Anyway, please like and subscribe.